Hey, what's up, YouTube fam? It's your boy Camo back with another reaction video for you. Today we got another NF1. Leave me alone. I really enjoyed the first one, and if you haven't seen it, I'll link it at the end of this video. But guys, seriously, I really appreciate when fans of other artists suggest their stuff for me, and then that's how I find out about them, and I'm digging them. And then you guys are really supportive of the channel. You guys like leave comments, you subscribe. You like the videos, all those things. I just want to say thank you guys. So for you, lately, I'm going to be honest with you, for you NF fans, Easy Mill. And actually, I think that's it. But also, I had someone that was a fan of both of them recommend to Snow the Product. So either that video is already out on my channel or it's going to be coming out soon. But I appreciate all these suggestions, guys. With that out of the way, let's get it going with NF. Leave me alone. Okay, so right away I'm gonna say he's got the cart and the balloons again. So I think this is from some of you fans from the previous video had told me that this is part of like his journey. So I guess, I mean, I know he has other videos that's not so technically part of his journey, but I think this one, when it was suggested to me, I was told that it was part of his journey from the other video as well. So I'm really curious how many of these are actually connected, and if I'm hopefully watching them in the right order, or I don't know if it matters, but if it's a journey, I would think that the order matters. Hopefully I'm watching it in a good order, but now something's telling me that maybe the last one I reacted to was probably the end. I don't know if that was the end of the journey. We'll see. Abandoned. Into the park.
Hey! Panic stricken. Handle business, not a joke, yeah. Manners missing, travel different, no control, yeah. Time to listen, time to zip it, keep it close. My description, highly gifted, take some notes, yeah.
So, right away, the visuals are drastically, well, they're different, but they're not. Obviously, I'm seeing like the scenery is, the last one, he was just in a barren land. Later, you guys told me it was Iceland. You know, he's in an abandoned amusement park. I guess there was people in the last video, but like these ones have kind of a different energy. I feel like obviously he's got some paint on, like almost like a Joker smile. So I'm really trying to figure out how this journey's going, if I'm watching it in the right order.
Lack of interest, why'd you visit? Hit the road, yeah, I'm kind of twisted, so keep your distance, be a ghost. Yeah, see, I'm invented, but quite the menace. You ain't know, well then I'm offended. Let's jog your memories, here we go, yeah. I went from no...
I'm sure he gets this a lot, and I do not, I'm fully admitting right now, I do not know a lot about music in general. Like, I really don't. Movies, I'm really great with. Stand-up comedies, like comedians, I'm really great with. Music is my weakest one. With that being said, I'm saying this because to me, there's moments where he really reminds me of Eminem, but I'm saying that because I'm like, I don't know if people are like, dude, he sounds nothing like Eminem, because I'm just how I remember Eminem sounding. He has parts of it that I'm like feeling like it's a lot like him, but in either case, I'm like, there might be other people that you're like, dude, he sounds more like this guy. Like, I don't know. But to me, I'm picking up a lot of Eminem right now. And even with some of his, movements. But just like that part right there before I paused it. When he went into that, it kind of did remind me of Eminem.
Buddy, the kind of famous. Hide my plaques inside a closet, I just can't explain it. My wife, she tells me that she's proud and thinks that I should hang them. But I just leave them on the ground right next to my self-hatred. Yeah, yeah, mental health. Where's my mental health? Diagnosed with OCD, what does that mean? We'll gather around. That means I obsessively obsess on things I think about. That means I might take a normal thought and think it's so profound. Ruminate.
Okay, so wait. Oh, shit. Okay, I'm going to have to rewind a little bit. But is this... true, like, do you guys know if, like, when this is, like, saying his journey, is this, like, literally, like, kind of going through, like, let's say his, like, journal or his diary, like, because, like, he just talked about having OCD, and I'm like, wait, does he really have OCD, or is he just rapping about somebody, like, fictitious, like, I'm trying to piece them together, because this is, again, this is only the second video I've ever seen of his. I'm super intrigued, but I'm also, like, unaware of a lot of things. But I got to rewind that again because I also think it was about to. I just feel like I got to go, like it dropped a beat. So let me go back a little bit.
Where's my mental health? Diagnosed with OCD, what does that mean? We'll gather around. That means I obsessively obsess on things I think about. That means I might take a normal thought and think it's so profound. Ruminating, fill balloons are full of doubts. Do the same things. If I don't, I'm overwhelmed. Thoughts are pacing. They go round and round and round. It's so draining. Let's move on to something else.
Dude, like, his lyrics are... Obviously, they're fucking really good and they're so profound, but like the story he's telling, like he's a good, like what I'm trying to say is he's a great storyteller, like period. And again, music, not my, but from what I know, there's, you know, there's good rappers, there's guys that are just good at rapping, period. But then there's good rappers who are great storytellers. And I feel like those ones are like, they're on another level, you know? And right now, I would put him on that level, having only seen 1.25 of his videos so far.
Running the game if they don't even know it. Like I'm undercover and knowing to blow it. They come out and know it, they don't even notice. The flow is so cold, you would think it was slowing. I'm under the weather, but wind isn't blowing. I got an umbrella for difficult moments. You gotta admit it, I'm very devoted. I'm out in the rain, but it don't always open, so I... Hold up my balloons and cover up my face. I can feel them weighing on me every day. I should let them go and watch them float away. But I'm scared if I do, then I'll be more afraid. Tell them how I feel, but they don't want to change. Tell them how I feel, but they remain the same. Loosen up my grip, they say that's not okay. Quiet, 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 hey, leave me alone.
Wow.
Hey, yeah. Quiet, 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 yeah. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. Yeah.
I gotta find out what the significance is of the black versus the white, because I know in the other video it ends with someone giving him a white uniform. So I gotta know, because there was obviously a couple people there that were wearing black also, but majority were wearing white. And you know, he's putting the smiley faces on him, and now they're all getting them wiped off, and I'm like, I gotta know what the significance
is.
I'm not super great with symbolism sometimes. I'm great at it. Not right now.
Debated for underrated. We're so overlooked that they're looking over our numbers, Nathan. We don't do enough interviews or go out in public lately. We don't post enough on our socials to keep the buzz from fading. Let it fade, yeah.
That's got to be so fucking real for these guys. I feel like that was truth for sure. Like, that you're when you're put in that situation, the people that make money off of you are going to try and do whatever they got to do to keep you making the money. And so they'll want you to do stuff even if it doesn't, like, kind of go with your, you know, artistic integrity, you know? Like, you know, there's some celebrities that don't post on social media. Like, they don't have a social media account. And it's, like, good for them. If they feel like that, if you're not a person that would have already used something like that. Because, I mean, there is celebrities that use social media that I'm, like, totally cool with because... they probably are the type of people that would use social media anyway, but there's certain types that would not, but they do anyway. But then there's a few that would not and do not. And it's like, if when you have it like to where you're just like, that's just not me, and I'm not going to do that just to try and do this so like I can appear to be this way and hopefully sell you more whatever you want to try to sell me as, like I'm just going to be me. Which was another thing that a lot of you guys were mentioning in the comments about, like, just do it my way, and if people don't like it, they cannot watch, but like, just to do it my way. Right now, guys, I'm doing it my way. I'm pausing, I'm talking. That's what I normally do, but there's a couple music videos that I didn't do that, and people got pissed off. Well, I did one music video, and I paused too much, and the person got pissed off that I was ruining the video, so then I tried to change my way by not pausing a lot during music videos because people want to see the music video. But then I had so many of you actually reply and say, dude, pause it. I come to watch the reaction for the reaction. If I want to see the actual music video, I'll go find the music video. I don't need to see you watching the music video. So I appreciate that. Now you're getting a lot of how I normally roll. Sorry.
Yeah, let it fade. Once it's decimated, then you drop a song out of nowhere and all the fans embrace it. Then the buzz will surface again. It's part of my operation. I don't need advice from my gods right now. End of conversation. Shut your mouth, yeah. Shut your mouth. Better tone it down.
He's got the white.
If you make a sound, I'ma change it down. Funny how they be acting loud. Coming on it now. Floating show it. I keep it together, but have a disorder. I go to my room and I sit in my corner and talk to myself in a language that's foreign. I think of a rhyme and I have to record it, but no, if I don't, I wake up in the morning and question my life again, always avoiding. I hate to be different, but I hate to be normal, so I hold up my balloons and cover up my face. I can feel them weighing on me every day. I should let them go and watch them float away. But I'm scared if I do, then I'll be more afraid.
Wow. So I mean, that last part, that last minute or so really hit me hard about him. Like, I don't know why that made me emotional right now, like about him wanting to hide his face with his balloons. But then there's times he just wants to cut him and let him fly away, but he's more afraid of that. It's like, dude, I've felt that way sometimes, you know. I felt that way where you're like, you feel like you're damned if you do, you're damned if you don't. Like, it's like there's sometimes you just feel like the grass isn't greener on the other, like, you know, all these metaphors you want to talk about. But like, dude, that hit me. Like, man, that's some good shit.
Tell them how I feel, but they don't want to change. Tell them how I feel, but they remain the same. Loosen up my grip, they say that's not okay. Quiet. No name, I said fan called. Told you I hung up, it kind of felt wrong. Finally called him back, we didn't talk long. He asked me how I'd been, I sent him this song. Yeah, think he took offense, he kind of seemed off. I texted him that night to ask what he thought. It took a couple days to get a response. But once I finally did, he said this song sucks. Feel the symptoms, wow. Couldn't miss him, wrestle with him. Then I pin and flip him. Brought some backup, no way, you should get some. Who you dissing? Mood is switching, don't come in the kitchen. You should listen. Cooking record for my hands are blistering. So persistent, don't forget this. Hold the tension, soul is bending, no pretending. No.
Is that just, I feel like that was, that whole scene, I feel like was representative of people who just give up. Like, just give up and die. So it's like, again, I suck at symbolism. I'm totally guessing here, but I feel like I'm getting it. I'm getting a lot of it right now. Like, I feel like it's coming together. Maybe that was a plan. Maybe I wasn't supposed to fully get it until it was almost over, as is life. But I get it. I feel like that was really representative. Obviously, there's people that just go along with society, go along with the, you know, what you're supposed to do, that type of mentality. And he's fighting that normalcy, whatever you want to call it. He's fighting that. And then he sees other people that were like, yeah, fuck that. I'm not doing it either. But then they just go and like give up on life, period. Like they just give up and die, you know, live on the streets or whatever. I don't know if that was literally where he was going with that, but that was what the scene was. And he's like, no, fuck that. Like he's not giving up, but he's not just going to conform to what society wants him to be, is what I'm getting. Please tell me if you know, like if he's done interviews about this or whatever, and you already know that I'm way off, then you can tell me. You'd be like, yeah, dude, you're way off. That's not at all. Like you were talking out your ass right there, bro.
Demented, whole consensus, all tremendous. No apprentice, no incentive, show intensive, so possessive, tone aggressive. Watch your step when I hold up my balloons and cover up my face. I can feel them weighing on me every day.
Yeah,
I should let them go and watch them float away. Yeah, float away. But I'm scared if I do, then I'll be more afraid. Leave me alone. Yeah. Leave me alone. Yeah. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. Yeah. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. Yeah, leave me alone. Yeah. Leave me alone. Leave me alone.
See, okay, see, like, again, symbolism. Earlier when he was around all the people, his balloon, again, I don't know if this was intentional or not. I could be just a fucking whatever. Maybe there was a windy day that his balloons were low and it wasn't hiding his face very well. I know there's a part where he walked away from the car completely, but when he was near the car, there was a part where the balloons were low so you could still see him. And I was like going to say that in the other scenes, his balloon was higher and it was covering his face. And now as he's walking by all these people, it's covering his face again. So I'm like, okay. Where you going, bro? Where you going?
Wow.
I said it once and I'll say it again. Wow. NF, leave me alone. I think his name's Nate, right? Nathan, Nate. Dude, that was the only symbolism I don't get was the very one at the end, but I'm going to probably be thinking about it for a while because that was very poignant. You know, that was a very period to the end of that sentence. Thank you guys so much for suggesting it. As always, guys, if you could please like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't. When you do subscribe, put in the comment section that you subscribe. That way I can actually thank you because I don't always get notified when people subscribe. And even if I do, I'm not able to just straight up like message them. But if you are able to comment that you subscribed, I would love to thank you for that. And with that out of the way, thank you guys for watching. I appreciate you. Until next time.